Hi, it's Mirek here from Abbey Road Studios, and in this video we are going to look at drum enhancement and drum replacement in a mixed situation. This video is going to focus on the kick drum, but you could easily use these techniques on the snare drum or the toms. So I've got this recording here. It's been given to me by someone else. I didn't record it, and I'm gonna mix this song. And I'm just getting my bearings here, listening to, you know, the various sort of options and takes. And the kick drum is fine. There's nothing particularly wrong with it, but it's just not particularly inspiring. So what I'm going to do is show you some of the techniques I would use to just enhance the kick drum and get me to a better place. So what I'll do is I'll just play you the original kick drum recording here. So yeah, it's fine, but we can work on this. We can make it a bit better. So the first thing I do is just very surgical. So I've just got a basic EQ here, the Avid EQ, and I'm gonna clear up everything below 50 hertz, so a high pass filter, because I feel like I don't really need that information down there. And if you don't need the information, then just get rid of it, because it's gonna clutter up your mix at the end of the day. Same on the reverse with the top end. I've got a low pass filter, and for me personally, I don't feel like I need anything past 8K in this kick drum recording. So again, if you don't need it, just get rid of it. It will just clear up your mix. I'm also adding a gain reduction of about 5 dB at 400 hertz. For me, 400 hertz is always like the muddiness, like the boxiness of a recording. So I generally cut around 400 hertz in most kick drum recordings, actually, because it just clears the kick drum up for me. So I will play you before and after with this surgical EQ. These are just small tweaks, but hopefully you'll hear a difference. So the next thing I do is add a basic compressor, just to sort of round it out a little, if you like. The Abbey compressor's got some great presets. I really like the kick thump preset. It's got like a relatively fast attack time, relatively fast release time. I just love this preset on kick drums. So I'll give you a before and after. So yeah, it's just lifting up the volume, if you like, a little, and just sort of rounding out the transients a little bit. The next thing I'm gonna do is add a gate. Now gating a kick drum isn't for everyone. I'm gonna do it in this situation because it will actually play into something I'm gonna do later on. But yeah, adding a gate, it can really clean up the recording, if you like. So all those snares that are bleeding through into the kick drum microphone, you can kind of pretty much get rid of those with a gate. They can sound quite harsh sometimes, so you've got to be careful how you use them. And these settings here obviously work for the kick drum recording I've got, but you need to really play around with the gate settings depending on the kick drum you're working with to get a desired outcome. But I'll give you a before and after, and you're going to really hear this one. I mean, it's quite a dramatic kind of effect you get from a gate. So we've lost our tail, but we're going to add that back in later, so that's okay. But yeah, adding a gate to kick and snare recordings in some situations, if you like that sort of sound, can really help your drums cut through the mix. The next thing I do, talking of cutting through the mix, is a transient master designer, transient designer plugin, if you like. This is the Native Instruments one, which is called Transient Master. Most doors come with some sort of transient designer plugin. This is going to make the kick drum sound quite snappy. I've got the attack here up by about 15%. I've backed the sustain off a little bit as well, so we're kind of, again, getting less of the decay, and then you get more of the attack, more of the snappiness of the kick drum. And again, this is going to help the kick drum cut through the mix. So again, I'll give you a before and after. Now that's quite dramatic, and transient designers are great for enhancing drums. They really are fantastic. And the next thing I do is I'm going to add a character compressor, if you like. This is the Waves TG Desk plugin. The compressors on the TG Desk are quite aggressive compressors. Luckily, on the plugin version, there's actually a mix control down here, so you can kind of blend in the original recording with the compressor effect, if you like, so you can kind of back off that aggression a bit and sort of blend it in a bit more, which is a good thing. Got the recovery on one, the hold on zero. This is quite an aggressive compressor. You're going to really hear this, but again, it's going to help it cut through the mix once you've got all the other instruments playing. So I'll give you a before and after. So yeah, that's quite a snappy effect going on there, but that's what I want for this kick drum. So let's hear the before and after. So I'll play the original recording without any of the plugins I've just added, and then I'll flip over to the recording with all the plugins, and we can hear the difference. So there we go, that's with the plugins. We're sounding a bit more clinical at the moment, I admit, but we're gonna do some things later on to sort of add some of the, add some room and some air around it. So the first thing I do is gonna be to add some low end emphasis, and I'm gonna do that using an 808 sample. Now the way I'm gonna do that in this scenario is to use an audio to MIDI converter plugin. I'm going to use a plugin called the Massey plugin, Massey drum replacement plugin. Most DAWs, even I think the newer version of Pro Tools now, just come with audio to MIDI converter as standard, but I'm just going to use the Massey plugin because it's sort of what I know and what I like. So the reason I'm doing this is that once you could convert those kick drum notes, the audio, if you like, into MIDI, you can then use that MIDI to trigger any other sounds you want. So we're gonna trigger a 808 kick drum. What we do is we highlight the audio we want to convert to MIDI, hit the analyze button, and as you can see, we've got the kick drums highlighted here, but it's also picked up some of the snare drums and that sort of thing. So I'm just gonna back off the sensitivity a little because we're just interested in the kick drum notes. So I'm gonna back them off. And you'll see eventually we will end up with just the kick drums. There we go. All we're seeing now are the kick drums. So that's that done really. So what I can do is I can drag that MIDI down onto a MIDI track. Get rid of that Massey plugin. And then I've just got to manually line it up here to make sure that the MIDI notes are lined up with the kick drum transients in the recording, which they are now, so that's good. And then what I need to do is just grab my MIDI and make sure triggering what I want to trigger, which is the kick drum. So I've got the boom instrument here by Air. Let's make sure I'm triggering the kick drum. There we go, that's the kick drum. And make sure again that I really am lined up here with the actual kick drum recording. If you don't have your MIDI notes absolutely lined up, then you're gonna get very sloppy sounding triggers basically. So let's hear before and after. So I'll just play the kick drum recording and then we'll add the 808 sample underneath and hear what that sounds like. So it's quite subtle, and you can make it less unsubtle if you want. But it's adding a lot of weight to the kick drum. It's a nice effect. And I mean, the great thing about the 808 is that you can use the tune control to play around with the tuning, if you like, so that it kind of locks in a bit more with the original kick drum recording. It's also a good thing to check the 808 sample up against the bass guitar as well, for example, and just make sure you're kind of locked in a bit there. The next thing I'm going to do is I've duplicated that MIDI track, and I'm now going to trigger the Native Instruments Abbey Road Modern Drummer. So we've got a drum workshop drum kit here, recorded in Studio 2, and what I'm going to do is just use the kick drum from this instrument. So I've muted all the other instruments, the snares, the hi-hats, toms, all that sort of stuff, and the overheads. I just want to hear the kick drum sample and a little bit of the room mixed in. And this is to add a bit more decay and tail and a bit more of a natural sound back into the kick drum. So first of all, I'll play without the Studio 2 sample, and then I'll play with. So yeah, it's adding a bit more air around the recording. It's adding more decay, and it's just making everything sound sort of a bit more natural. So there we have it. So let's hear the original recording without any of the plugins, without any of the samples, and then we'll flip over to all the enhancements I've just added, and hopefully you'll hear a big difference. So there we have it. It's a big difference there, and it's going to basically inspire me to move on with the rest of my mix. So let's hear the rest of the track now with the rest of the drums. There's a guitar and there's a vocal there, and I'll play the song with the original kick without any of the enhancements we've just done, and then I'll flip over to our new kick drum if you like, and hopefully you'll hear a big difference there. Speak So there we have it. Hopefully you found that inspiring and useful, and please leave comments below.